Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for TCG Player, Channel Fireball, and Ultimate Guard, and today I'm going to be playing Modern with the new set with Lord of the Rings. I'm going to be playing Abzan Kokombo. What a terrible name, I know. And yeah, that's the very first League of Modern I'm playing with the new set, and I decided to try the all the new combos packed in one deck. So first I'm gonna go over the combos, the two different combos, how they work. I'm gonna talk about like maybe a couple different builds you could do for this deck, talk about the sideboard, the mana base, etc. So yeah, first combo is Rosie Cotton up Southlane plus Scurry Oak. Basically, if you have both in play, you have Rosie in play and you play Oak, or if you accompany them in play, Rosie says whenever you create a token, put a +1/+1 counter on target creature you control other than Rosie. And Scurry Oak says whenever one or more +1/+1 counters are put on it, you may create a 1/1 squirrel token. So what happens is she enters the battlefield, you get a food token. Since you get the food token, you get to use her trigger, put a +1/+1 counter on Scurry Oak. Oak gets a counter, so he makes a squirrel, a 1/1 squirrel. The 1/1 squirrel triggers Rosie again, which means you get to put another counter on the Oak. So basically you get an infinitely large Scurry Oak as well as infinite 1/1 squirrels, and that's it. So you don't kill them right away, but if you're playing against anything that's fair-ish, you should untap and kill them pretty easily. The other combo that kills them on the spot is Familiar plus Samwise Gamgee and a Sack Owlet, so either Woestrider or Viscera Seer or Yogg. So you need a Sack Owlet that doesn't cost mana, because basically Samwise says whenever another non-token creature enters the battlefield under your control, create a food token. So whenever your cat enters the battlefield, you get a food, then you sack it to one of your free sack outlets, and then you bring it back with the food you got, you get another food, etc. So that's like infinite damage. Each opponent loses one life and you gain a life, so it actually dodges the One Ring, I believe, because you're not targeting and you're not dealing damage, so that could be relevant in the new format. Note that Yogg works, because even though you pay the life, every time you sack, you get the life back from the cat. So all these sack ally works. And then we'll see if we have a bunch of games where we just draw bits and pieces and just beat people down. I want to play this deck because it has a lot of new cards. It has Samwise, Rosie, and Halfling. Halfling is a 1/2, taps for colorless or taps for mana of any color to cast a legendary spell, and that spell can't be countered. So Grist, Rosie, Samwise, and gives you double black with for Yogg, which is nice. That card just seems super strong. It dodges Lavadar. More importantly, it dodges the Renping. Yeah, if you played Modern, you know that if you're on the draw and you go turn one mana dork and they go turn two Renping your mana dork, it feels like the game almost ends on turn two sometimes, so that's important. And still playing four Birds of Paradise, you could just play Halfling and no other one drops, just the Familiar, the Halflings, maybe some Seers, maybe some Ovens. Yeah, and to round out the deck, I've got Wall of Roots and company, one Grist. I tried to keep the main deck as focused as possible on the combos, because usually these decks are strongest game one, and after sideboard, people have interaction for your combo, maybe graveyard hate, maybe cards that stop coming into plays and whatnot. So just the one Grist in the main, because it's a strong card, you can hit it off company. Another build you can do is you could play Finale, Green Finale, kind of as a tutor for your combo pieces, and play Asmo in the deck, play Asmo and maybe Urza's Saga. That's nice. It gives you a different angle that doesn't rely on the graveyard. So that's always nice. Yeah, and then obviously you could just play one of the combos, just like Familiar, Samwise, combo only, maybe a bigger food theme. Maybe you could play Ovens or Trails. I considered putting ovens and trails in, you know, very small numbers, but in the end I decided to focus on the combo. You could play, you know, obviously figure out how many woe striders you want, how many seer, how many yogs. Mana base is fairly straightforward. 22 lands, 2 Baseju, because Baseju is going to get rid of some of the hate cards, and maybe Tron decks are going to be popular with the One Ring. If that deck is good, having way to slow them down could be good, and I'm playing the one Takenuma. Note that you have a lot of legends, so those lands go up in value. And then some fetch lands, some basics, some fast lands. Sideboard has a lot of collected company targets, Loran Endurance, Grist, one value tracker, cleric. I'm trying cleric. I think maybe Living End gets a boost with the land cyclers. I think the land cyclers are going to make Living End a bit stronger, so that deck is already popular and good. And I wonder if cleric's just not better than endurance against them. Boromir is another hate card. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, if no mana was spent to cast it, counter that spell. So counters the cascade spells, and it has a nice little bonus ability of saving your team, so trying that card out. And then trying a couple of Reprieve, just try and punish big mana decks, try it out. I think that card could be very cool with more Wall of Roots, because it would you know, it's pretty tempting to go Wall of Roots, use it on your turn, keep one white mana up, and then you get to Reprieve for quote unquote one mana on their turn. That could be a nice little synergy. So yeah, that's the deck. I'm gonna get in my first league. A modern league with Abzan combo. Get in the match, and while we look for our first opponent, pretty big announcement. CFB has a new and improved website, and along it, a new and improved CFB Pro. CFB Pro is top-notch content from some of the best players in the world. Strategy guides, deck guides with sideboard guides, pretty in-depth stuff if you're looking to level up your competitive game and use the resources out there. Really great investment, in my opinion. You can check it out by using the promo code Second Breakfast for a free trial of the TCG Player subscription. CFB Pro comes with TCG Player subscription. It's usually $7 a month, but right now, yeah, promo code Second Breakfast, you get a free trial, and you know, get to decide if you like it or just, you know, use a few trial and move on. But I'm sure the link will be in the description down below or a reminder. And yeah. Video is brought to you by TCG Player ChannelFireball, as well as Ultimate Guard. Ultimate Guard makes some of the best, if not the best, sleeves and deck boxes in the world. Really insane quality. Just super good stuff. Love the sleeves, the katana sleeves especially. Love the deck boxes, the feel of them, the sidewinders that I use for tournaments. Yeah, they're really nice high-end deck boxes and sleeves for your magic cards. All right, Modern League. No, I figured the leagues would be like pretty busy right now. You know, I guess maybe people are drafting or waiting to get some cards. Maybe it's early for some people, I guess. But yeah, this is the first deck I'm trying. I wanna try Living End with the Land Cyclers. And maybe press the enemy. I'll show you my little very high-end text document. That's kind of the cards I think might have an impact. Some of the cards are probably loose, but the One Ring, obviously, the new 4-mana artifact, that card could be really good. Probably the most hyped up card in the set. Flowering of the White Tree, that's a crusade. I don't think that card's gonna see a ton of play. I don't think these legendary old creature decks are gonna be good enough. Boromir, let's see if it does anything for me. Forge Anew is an equipment card. Seems like people think it's good in Hammer Time. Press the Enemy is the new kind of 4-mana reman that lets you play a spell. All right, so I have parts of the combo. I have 4 lands. They're on the play. I think I'm just going to go ahead and keep. little girl logo. Let's put it here. Ooh, Ragavan. This is another spot where Halfling is better than Burrs. Just, being able to trade was a Ragavan if possible. All right, looks like we're gonna be put to the test right away. But yeah, I guess I'll finish. I'll go over the list real quick. Yeah, Orcish Bowmaster. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention. I wanted to play Orcish Bowmaster in my sideboards, and it was too hard to get a hold of them. But yeah, for specifically Ragavan decks, wow, brutal. We're not even going to cast it. Sorin's Bronstem's a new 3-mana card drawing spell, kind of between Factor of Fiction and Shadow Prophecy. Flame of Anor is a blue-red burn spell, Reprieve on playing. That's another card I forgot, Battle of Bywater. It's kind of a sweeper. That card could be good. It's, I think, creatures fear was power 3 or more. Birds going bye-bye. Got an interesting spot here. I might just take it at this point. We'll see. I mean, I'm clear if my Samwise is going to live. Rosie, I'm playing in this deck. Samwise is the 2-1 for 2 flash that lets you bring back a permanent that left play this turn. So like a fetch land, a bubble, a creature that die. Stern Scalding is a 1-mana counterspell. Arwen's another card I could have thrown in this deck just as a one of. Try it out, more new cards. It's a white-green free drop Samwise GG or games you haven't planned. Smeagol. I thought about Smeagol, it's a black-green 4-2, but my deck's not that great at second creatures. It's just another one of these value cards you can play, a bit like a Tireless Tracker, but I feel like Tracker would be better. Maybe Smeagol would be better in actual Yogg, but maybe it's just too mopey. Oh, one thing cool about Smeagol, it one-shots, if these decks become popular, it one-shots the Oops All Spells deck because you mill them. You basically mill them. This one, I kind of want to take it. Start getting my food, set up my combo. Wow, I have big plans for that Ragavan. Not trading. Okay. Even better. I think I was blocking. All right, I forget. Did I end up putting 2 basic force or did I go down to 1? I kept 2. All right. Well, I have the combo. But 1 mana short right now. And then Samwise does have a second relevant ability. Sacrifice, free freeze, return target historic card from a graveyard or hand. Historic is artifact, legendaries, and sagas. So, get back your Yogg. Back your Rosie. Another Samwise, maybe. I think it's pretty safe to say they don't have a removal spell. Should not have 6 here. Is it a side to kill? Oh no. How does it work? Keep pressing F5. Alright, I guess I'm F6. Oh well. Counter spell's not stopping me, so yeah, if they don't have a removal spell, I win next turn. Assuming by now, we would have heard something if they had it. Mean, does it matter? Sure, another samurai seems fine. Since it's the most fragile part of my combo. All right, nice. So in this matchup, they could bring in. Is graveyard hate even that good? If I have two food, graveyard hate does nothing. Well, some graveyard hate does. I was thinking about her specifically. Right, let's see. Veil seems okay, but not great. Veil a little worse against the halfling because some of their spells already count. That card, no mana. It counters bubble. It counters bubble. It makes my creature indestructible. Not super exciting. Endurance seems solid. Grit seems solid. Not too much I want to board out. I guess Wall of Roots is not great against them. I can probably trim Baseju against a deck that has no great targets. I didn't try one Veil in this matchup. Seems kind of nice with company though, but it's also a lot of mana. Reprieve is nice against Murktide, but that's it. Cleric not good enough. I mean, I could do Knight or Loran. I could do tracker for value too if I think the games are going to go this way, but I think the games I'm going to lose are it's just going to be losing to their flyers and their beatdown. So I don't think I'm going to do tracker. Think I'm going to stay combo strong. Maybe Yogg is not that great against them because they kill all my other creatures anyways. All right, let's do that. A little greedy to cut Wall of Roots, but it's not as effective on the draw against Ragavan to get that first hit in. I mean, I don't think this hand is great, but I think it's good enough to keep. I like that I have my mana. I like that I have a blocker for Ragavan. All right, dubs of each. Could have gotten basic swamp. It's most of my lands make white. And when I say most, I mean slightly over 50%. I mean like 60%. Oh, looks like they mulliganed. Didn't draw a one or a two drop. I did board out some Wall of Roots. I don't think I need to land right now. Doesn't even help me against Blood Moon. I think I would have kept exactly basic planes there, just as a hedge against potential Blood Moon. Okay. They have four cards in hand. This is where the clunkiness of this combo shows. It's possible. I mean, my first instinct when people were mentioning this combo was that it was too clunky for modern in a format where Lightning Bolt and Unholy Heat and whatnot are vastly played. I want to play a second Curio first. Does that make sense? I'm just going to go for it. Hopefully this heavy removal spell me to just have old counters. I mean, I doubt it, but... Really? There's no way, right? That they don't have a bolt or a counter spell. Yeah. Okay. Thing is, if I play a Scurry Oak first, they can just bolt a Rosie. Is really bad against removal. I mean, yeah. Not having a two, being on the draw. Do you have Lightning Bolt as well? It has bolted crests, they misclicked. Oh, that was weird. It just tunnel vision, I guess. Didn't realize. Oh! Oh no, this is non-token. Non-token. No, this makes me a food. So I can go up to 5. Yeah, I can go up to 5, but that's not enough, right? I mean, to be fair, this game should already be over. It's possible I just want to trim the Scurrier Crozy combo, honestly. I could go like... I could bring in... like maybe these 8 cards and trim that combo. The Rosie is kind of fine on its own. Yeah, let's just learn from our lesson here and totally trim that combo. That would be like probably my plan. Almost definitely if I had Bowmaster in my sideboard in this matchup. Nice hands. Turn to, they don't kill my halfling. I've turned to a wall of roots into Samwise. My wish this was just a Rosie. Let's see. All right, I think I'm going to play Samwise first to get the food tokens going. Is that greedy? It's all greedy. I'll play Wall of Roots first. The food tokens are not very important. Whereas casting an early endurance could be. Spell Snare. Oh, that is good for them. This was the kind of the reprieve spot I was talking about. Bounce my wall. Wow. Do you have another spell snare? Because they could have cast a Murktide here. 5/5 Murktide. A Veil last turn would have been sick, actually. Veil on the Brazen Boar. I mean, maybe I should Endurance. I feel like if I Endurance, I'm just going to lose their... One, two, they have a 6/6 Murktide. I have played a 5/5 Murktide last turn. They fetch first, and they're playing Iteration. I mean, now it's starting to feel like I should just Endurance. Well, I just lose to a 7/7 Murktide. They're at 13. I have Samwise plus Boromir left. All right, I'm going to Endurance. It also make like they're unholy heat worse. Their channeler like all slower to like Shredder. All right, I think this is fine. Counterspell, wow. If you want to have Veil in hand, it's not a good sign. Oh, maybe it means they have another one. All right, could be worse. They're racing 2/2. Press down. Okay. Let's see if I can win a race. Yeah, I'd already back to a 6/6 Murktide like 2 turns later. I mean, that endurance play was not the greatest. That is a very bad sign. That probably means Merc. Right, the ring tempts me. Yeah, I'm gonna hold on to my veil. They're discarding really good cards, so they probably have a counter spell in hand. I think they're relevant here. My Samwise can't be blocked. I'm gonna hold on to the bird one turn. So that I have 5 mana. We're getting pretty low. All unlucky here. Like, they don't have removal. They must have counterspell in hands. I think I really need to hold on to that veil and pray for company. I mean, I got them pretty low. Obviously they could have held back a bit. Maybe I'll get scared and they'll counter that, and then I can veil and stuff. Let's hope they don't have counterspell somehow. I have no cards in hand, and I'll have to just counter that veil, and I lose. Yeah. All right, GG's. One. That was close. That's kind of close. I didn't draw company in either game, which is probably one of my best cards. Maybe I played that endurance a little too early. Okay. All right, they're gonna down to 6 as well. Wow. You go down to 4 here, or do you just keep and hope you draw green mana? Could keep land, Melior, Wolof Roots, Yogg, and birds. So let's see, I'm like 16 sources of green, so I'm like 30% to hit. If I go down to 4, I'm probably way less. Bird actually gives me white mana. That flings better against blue cards and stuff. Yeah, I mean, Takenuma has a price. If it wasn't Takenuma, it would probably be not a fetch land or dual land. Allergies must be back. I don't know. I'm not really allergic too much, but been sneezing a bit this morning. Other lands I could be playing are Yavimaya and Yawgmoth. Don't know if I really need them, and I feel like sometimes these lands help your opponent more than they help you. Nope. Snow-covered islands. Who plays that? Spirits? Usually. He likes blue controls, scrying sheets and whatnot. Blue or red. Maybe just a deck that wants different basics. Some people just like snow-covered basics, I guess. They play them because why not? Alright. Ripe for the spell snare. I'm gonna play Halfling first since it makes a Yawgmoth counterable. I like it, you know, double Merc died in the first two rounds. Reality check. See if you can beat one of the best decks in the format. Dump all my creatures, and next turn I can play Yogg off Halfling, hopefully, and reg them. All right, they're not killing Halfling. Yeah, what else do I want to try? Living In was the Land Cyclers, some One Ring decks, whether it's, you know, maybe Tron, maybe Artifact, maybe it was Teferi and Omnath. Bust out the list again. I already forgot. Guess mostly that. Oh, Thorin's Ransom in a bunch of decks too, whether it's blue-black controlled Grixis, maybe in the Gore's Vengeance deck because the card puts cards in the yard. Right. We have a Merc. Murky Merc. All right, let's kill a channeler first. Not even sure I care about Dragavan that much. I might, I guess, if I sack all my creatures. I mean, I have a 2/4 to block. All right, we have the combo. Except I don't have a way to get the initial food token. I need to draw a green source. Let's sag the cat. There we go. Combo assembled. Do you have a removal for Samwise? Doesn't appear so. Alright, just like last match. We got game one was a cat food combo somehow. Just didn't draw a lot of removal spell. Maybe they're thinking for the combo, figuring out if it's lethal. Or do they have a removal spell and want to use it now? But I actually had a removal spell. Wow. There's no point in me. Wait, no. They can't stop the loop, right? It's too late. Just sag the cat. Oh no, right, I don't have a food. Oops. Alright, well, at least we get value and I'm just gonna finish it off now. Do I have to? I already have 6 mana for next turn. I'll finish it up now. Why not? Alright, looks like we're just in dominating position here. They have 3 cards left. I don't think they can really do much. Yeah. Just even if I just draw a random creature should be enough. All right, let's do what we did last game, I think is good. Oh, one too many cards. Back out of a Seju. I don't think Cleric does enough. And for the other cards. I kind of like Rosie for value, but is it really better than any of my other cards? I don't think so. Okay, solid hand. Good stuff to do. Yeah, I think it was the Bowmasters. Like that third game I lost in the last match. Bowmaster feels like it would be a huge pain for them and the damage would add up, etc. Like I got them down to 2 and they drew a bunch of extra cards, so. Being weak to turn on a Ragavan on a draw is a little annoying for sure. If you expect like a million Ragavans, you can maybe play a Grazer mana base. Grazer's bouncing and stuff, but. Not the huge fan, biggest fan. I think the Yacht players established that. That was not the way to go. Are they going to make me look like a bad limited deck? Just trading 1 mana removal spells for my 2 mana creatures while they kill me and keep getting more card advantage, looks like it. Another way to go, so there's the, you can play the finale package or as a Sega Finale package, that's probably pretty strong. It would probably help you a decent bit against Murktide. Or you could play this version and keep company, but just instead of the Rosie and the Oaks, you just play Bowmasters and whatnot in the main deck, maybe some Hate Bears, maybe like, you know, more Grists, maybe Reprieve main. That's a good draw. Oh my god. Am I for real right now? Minus one food token. Whoopsie. Counterspell in the bin because I have halfling anyways. Counterspell and Islet in the bin. Channeler and Scalding Tarn in the bin. Oh, kept on top this time. That's not good. Removal spell incoming. We need to just get the fetch ranch, secure a land. Yeah, I'm gonna block. I have another one in hand. Ooh, company. Even what they saw, I don't think they're gonna have spell pierce or Luster Storm. It would be a little weird. The question is, do I play Takenuma first? All right, Boromir. Let's see. Familiar is part of my combo. Ghost Rider is nice value. I don't need another halfling. Boromir could be good. It stops bubble too. Yeah, I'm just going to do Cat and Ghost Rider. And I don't want to play Takenuma yet. I'm going to play Takenuma because they might let me double spell next turn. I also just have the Woe Strider ability. I can see Woe Strider escape being relevant in this matchup. Sag the goat. I'm not sure that's a play. Not sure what the sequencing is. Oh. I guess that doesn't even do anything right now. I need to resolve another creature. Are they just flooded? There's no way. Counterspell. I don't have a kill here. Don't have a food. I don't have a creature. I guess keeping that land was kind of bad in hindsight. We're not playing Yawk first, maybe. Hmm. That's like the food I'm missing, right? Does this game where I sequenced I should have a food in play right now. Oh my god. What a dumbass. Oh well. First time playing was the cards. Yeah, that was not great. That was not great at all. All right, let's stick to the plan. I don't think I'm losing because of my side. I mean, if anything, like, I mean, I guess you could have argued that on company, I could have just hit. Ooh, that's a risky hand. I think I need to mull. So maybe I'm just not supposed to play cat on the one here. Let's play Temple Garden. Gonna just play wool on two. Fetch. Plains or swamp? Maybe plains. Maybe swamp, I guess. Yeah, let's do that. Mean, who knows if I would have won last game with that food. They might have had something else in hand, but definitely didn't look great. That's kind of nice. You can get basic forest on the off chance of Blood Moon in their deck. Sometimes it's good, like, because they could be like, okay, I'm gonna kill their mana creatures, and then Blood Moon might get them. But I mean, I'd be shocked if they had Blood Moon on the draw. Maybe on the play, you can have one, a cheeky one Blood Moon. I'll block here. I see they're always gonna attack. It's a free roll for them. Ooh. I think I just like saying go here, maybe. Actually. No. Let's play the cards. So if I reprieve that, I get a food token, but I don't think it's worth it. It puts a creature in my yard for Takanuma. Then I'm guessing they're gonna go iteration. That'd be nice, or shredder, something I'm gonna be able to reprieve here. Just gonna fetch a dual land. Not to worry about Blood Moon. Just gonna say go and use Takanuma end of their turn. Or use my reprise. Uh-oh. Basic island. No steam vents. Interesting. Curse. Curse doesn't stop the combo, I think, if I have a second food in play. It might not be trivial to get a second food in play. A Yogg, a Boromir, or a Samwise? Let's take a Samwise, I think. Just cheaper. Pretty all weird on the mana. It's like a basic swamp. Let's make them have a removal for the halfling here. I'd also be able to get a Murktide as my reprieve. Would be nice to ever draw a collected company, feels like. Credit card's pretty good. It's not great, but I think I'm just gonna reprieve it anyways. Like even land is not a bad draw here. Well, oh. Awkward spot was the Wall of Roots. I guess keeping the Wall of Roots on free toughness is kind of important. Yeah, I don't love my land from last turn. I should have played the Yogg. For some reason, I thought I was still gonna have four mana to end of turn company untap Yogg, but obviously not the case. Oops. They go. You might just sack islet here. Still haven't seen a company. I mean, I'm assuming like it's not too hard to figure out that would be a company deck, but you never know. Yogg doesn't play company, maybe. And they have five cards in hand. Another iteration. Does land win me the game here? Think I'm 1 foot short, right? Yeah, I needed the sack outlets. But a sack outlet was the second food. If Yogg was just a seer, or yeah, it would have had to be exactly kind of seer. Maybe seer is good, especially in a world of Ragavan, just having seer turn one for Zim to use a removal spell or trade with Ragavan and these removal spell, you can get a little scry action. It's another hit of company, obviously. F three non-Murktide cards in hand. You gotta assume one is a removal or a counter spell. All right, I need Veil of Summer. Veil would be good. What else? Here's pretty good. Oh yeah. Only have double black. Mean, is there one that's better to bait? Maybe Yogg's just a better bait because it's more expensive. Either a company next turn, or if they have a removal spell too. Stern's Scolding. I'm not the only one playing the new cards. All right. Yeah. Murktide might just be lethal here. 1, 2, 3, 4. No. Couple short right now. 1, 2, 3, 4. So close, yet so far. Man, it was one turn late, or yeah. Just play four Viserys here. Or more Woe Strider. Woe Strider is just pretty solid card. I mean, all my cards have been solid. Like, Wall of Roots was good for me this game. I mean, this is just all combo pieces and whatnot. The Reprieve was all awkward, I guess. Was F6'd. Oh, that's kind of lame. I had a food token in play too. I don't know why they went for the cap. Maybe they noticed I was F6'd. Dude, I actually had Samwise on top. I mean, if their hand is bricks, I win. It's a big if, but that was unfortunate. That was a lot of little unfortunate things that happened this match. I assume Murktide would be tough though, but this made me kind of hopeful. I also don't have the Bowmasters, which would have been, I think, nuts every time. Like, maybe instead of Wall of Roots, just turn into four Bowmaster, four Gris, maybe. Yeah, just like cut the Rosie, cut Skury Oak, play four Bowmaster, four Grist. Then you have your combo part, and you have the Bowmaster Grist annoyance, and Yogg's really good in a lot of matchups. It's possible you're just a worse Yogg deck. Samwise does feel pretty fragile and a little mopey. so far against Shock on Holy Heat. But Yakon really turn 3 combo you. Well, I don't think you can. Maybe some of their good draws. Hers was as expected, like annoying but not unbeatable. That's why I didn't want to like have bring in stuff for her specifically, like knight and stuff. Just don't think it's worth it. Hers is annoying but doesn't totally stop you. All right, great hands. Let's see. Just get Temple Garden on one. Maybe I should bait with bird actually. Halfling is better than bird, I think, in this hand. Okay, basic plans doesn't really matter. Okay. Thing is, the oak Rosie combo doesn't actually save me from Interesting. Oak likes me keep Busehu in hand. Bird plus Samwise lets me not die to let's do that. Let's do Barrick plus Samwise. I keep doing it. Oh my god. What is wrong with me? There's like something else like that I did recently. That was the same thing. It was like two cards that you're supposed to play like one after the other, and I kept getting it wrong. Yeah, Oak and Rosie doesn't save you against Nexus Hammer Eater. That's another good reason not to go with the Oak plan. Ooh. Hello, you beauts. I think that's pretty good against them. Just chill. Yagen chill. Let's assume they have triple hammer. Does that even work? I mean, I guess just in case I should block, right? Why not? Why not block? Okay. I guess if they have like double hammer plus surge, they actually get me. So I have to block. On the greatest draw. Yeah, I mean, if you have triple hammer or double hammer surge. Okay, let them target the. Yeah. I would sack my Yogg if I could, but it's just not a legal play. At least the two hammers are on the rampant creature. All right. It's not a human, no. I guess I'll just play the Yogg first. That's kind of gross that they had double hammer surge. Almost better than triple hammer too. All right, they just have 2021. Wow, I did not think I was gonna lose this game. I was like, yep, already counting the money. Funny part is if I company, I think I just win was Rosy and Scurry. I don't know, maybe not. Alright, Reprieve terrible, Endurance terrible, Knight, Crist, Loran, yes, Force of Vigor, yes. Yeah, that combo just seems weak. Guess I like that it seems I was right about this combo. I don't have the best track record lately of predicting the good cards. I had a big whiff on Expressive Iteration, where I said it's just a sorcery speed anticipate. Obviously, I was being all hyperbolic, but yeah. Darren's Cleric Boromir. Cast a spell. No mana spent on it. They don't have that many zeros. Just bring in Tracker and then just leave one of each, I guess. Or just two Rosy. One of each is very ambitious, but why not? I guess Curio is also a green card for Force of Vigor. Alright, not a great hand. Did I win the die roll last game? Alright, won the die roll at a amazing hand and I lost. Well, to be fair, they had an extremely strong hand too, but yeah, it's never a good sign when you have kind of the nuts on the play and you still lose. Also, note that Concealed Courtyard kind of potentially cost me the game, depending on what I would have hit. Coming into play tapped in company. You would think between Wallet Roots and Mana Creatures, It wouldn't be a big deal even with company, but it does come up. Also, it did feel like I was just a bad Yogg deck last game, because if I just had like one extra cheap creature or something was my Yogg. Oh, it's my turn. Oh, their draw is really bad. Okay, I would like. Oh, you know what I just thought about? Hollow Moonlight. Hollow Moonlight is a card. What a pain. Maybe company's just not the way to go. Like my company, after playing my lands. Could play by me. Company into Moonlight. It's kind of annoying. Let's take bird just because it's flying. Interesting game. All right, I get to be on the draw this time against the Hammer Menace. One drop into Knight. Into two thirds of the combo. Oh, they're mulligan again. I have colored mana. How lucky. How unbelievably lucky. I thought I'd just drawn the last bit of the combo, but no. Need a little Samwise. Damn. Let's get some color, man, I think. Oh, I think it's worth saving the life here, the two life. All right, I need land, mana creature, or Samwise. Beat down, let's go. Too bad I don't have an oven. Oven would have been kind of okay against thingy. All right, I should probably just knight the eight. What did he keep? I guess they mulliganed. So they kept probably March, aid, drum, land. So they might have, I don't know, they might have a search in hand. That kind of makes sense. All right, well, I beat two non-functional draws. Well, I guess I haven't won yet. I'm probably gonna beat two non-functional draws. Although it's dumb. And Hammer Time has a fail rate, but you don't see Hammer Time doing that very often. One game, let alone two. Like, that is really nothing. Right, we're on the board. Okay, pretty solid hand. One, two, three, four. The Blazing KFC MTG. Love fried chicken. I don't know if that's what the KFC stands for, but. So I live near Paris in France, and there was actually the first Popeyes that fried chicken chain food that opened not too far from where I live, but I haven't had it yet. We have KFC. We've had KFC for a while, but last time, I mean, it was literally like over 10 years ago, and I think we had KFC and it was just soggy and stuff. It was like bad KFC, so haven't had KFC since. And I'm sure it's like franchise dependent and stuff. It depends. I just probably just got a little unlucky, but think that the like crisp, the batter was a little soggy, and the chicken didn't look like it was like super well cooked. Maybe I just got a bad batch, bad day. All right, it looks like we're up against burn. Didn't searing blaze our burn? They probably don't have searing blaze. I'm just gonna go for basic planes. You don't have black cards in hand. Play Samwise. Play Seer. Get a food token. Try and get a food token. If I force them to kill a Samwise, it's kind of a win too. They won't be Searing Blaze. It'll be like Lightning Helix or Bolt or something. Yeah, it's fine. They didn't Bolt the bird. I'm not a burn player. I don't know if you're supposed to Bolt the bird as a burn player. Could see it not being the case. Obviously, hand dependent too, but main phase skull crack. Oh, they have skewer. Right. So I can go Samwise bird, and I only lose to Boar's Charm plus a 1 mana free damage burn spell. I think company's got to be better here, right? Got the combo to kill them next turn. Or, yeah. It's a combo to kill them next turn. I do same targets, save targets. Let's see. It just does it. Sorry, they have to kill me. Wow, Magic Online is just beautiful. Look at it go. Okay, I think that's enough. Oh, I win. Okay, I guess they didn't have Boar's Charm in hand. All right, against Burn, I want Knight of Autumn. Does Chris gain life? No. Knight of Autumn for Yogg, maybe? I think it's probably a tough matchup. I mean, on paper, you're like, oh, food, this, death, cat, but I think in reality, it's just like Samwise just so fragile. He's my main source of life gain. Like, I'm not even sure I can keep something like that. Doesn't have cat, doesn't have company, two fetch lands. Doesn't have Rosie that just gives you food right away, at least. I'm just gonna maul on the draw. I think you need to be a little more ambitious. This looks better. I think Gris might just not be great. I have cats. I'm just gonna save the life, honestly. It's just almost a time walk, like 2 damage. Still ignoring the bird. Do they have Searing Blaze this time? They do Searing Blood too. Yikes. Alright, I see Wall first. Man, I wonder how many they have after sideboard. 4 Searing Blaze plus 2 or 3 Searing Blood. Yikes. So good. Alright, punished. Punished for no black mana. I'm gonna zap Skullcrack and then. Too bad Samwise didn't make a food when it came into play itself. That would have been nice. Not too sure what I'm hoping for here. Well, apparently nothing. Okay. Fair enough. Five hands. Sure. All right, hit me, dealer. Blooming March. Concealed Courtyard. I'll take it. Ooh. Let's see. I think I should go basic planes, Samwise, birds, food token secured. That's a little value. Might just block with Sam. I mean, I think they're gonna kill it, but maybe they don't kill it. Oh, that makes no sense. They don't kill it before attacking. Can you imagine Fury? Oof. Is that a Fury nightmare? They might have Lance Cure here, feels like, the way they're thinking about their plays and whatnot. Would that reveal company? Company's got to be good here. Familiar. And an Oak. Oak's good if I draw Rosie. I could just do double Familiar. Double Familiar seems good. I think it's going to be hard for them to make a comeback from double Familiar. I even have Knight if they brought in Rest in Peace. Can like double block a Goblin Guide or even block one on each if I want to. I'm not having a removal of her somehow. It was unreal. I wonder if they just got super greedy. I mean, playing Goblin Guide over playing a Searing Blood or something seems too bad, right? What's their hand? No Searing Blaze, no Searing, no Skewer, no Bolt. Wow, they had Bolt in hand? Oh. That is not the play. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Looks like we win. Just in case they have a bunch of mutagenic growth again. All right. Bunch of 2/1s. They kind of holding its own. The Ramsey combo was good in game one. I'd have to go back and watch the replay to see if it was like actually essential or something. Or if I had like in a good spot and if I had been like a Grace and a Bowmaster or something like that, I would have been fine as well. Because that was pretty low, right? I was at 7, they had one card in hand. So I didn't need something. Ooh, I rolled 6, well played by me. I'm gonna play Birds first, because I'd rather have Halfling, I guess. Like, if they're playing a Bolt Ren and 6 deck, it's better if I play Birds, because they go Birds, Removal. You go turn on Removal on the Birds, and then when I play Halfling, the Ren and 6 come ping it. I think just Halfling's probably slightly better card in general. Especially when I have good mana. Mm-hmm. Looks like we are up against creativity. So I could play Yogg, but I think it's just better to play a company when they sag their fetch land. Unless they don't sag their fetch land, and then, I mean, it's kind of obvious what I have. They're just not sag their fetch land. I'm just gonna cast my Yogg. I mean, technically, they could be a burn deck, I guess. It'd be funny if it was burn and I just shocked. I just didn't cast my game-winning company. I'm not getting burn vibes. Made a fetch lance. I mean, I guess it could be. Teferis, okay. Not too, too scary. Seer. Samwise Seer. Kill your Teferi. I think company's just better. Oh. I play company. What do I need? I need Samwise and Cat exactly. I think killing the fairies may be more important. Samwise Ghost Rider. Okay. Be nice against creativity. Your combo can still win. And kind of go over the top. You have some fodder to sack to their archons. I'm gonna save it at Yogg. Scrying is nice, but drawing cards is better, right? No removal for Samwise. I don't really have to do much here. Just attack. Yogg's pretty good against creativity because of the -1/-1. They could not be creative. No, they are creativity. They have lounge and stuff. Yeah, just play Seer and say go. You kind of have to deal with Yogg. Okay, that looks like someone who's dealing with Yogg. All right, pay one life. Okay, stack. That's not a cat. Okay, stack. Do I sag the Ghost Rider? I think I should. Do I sack Samwise? Because I have another one. Maybe I just save each sec to Archon. Ooh, plus they get a food value. I have six. I should not have six in these spots with Seer in play. Bad habit. I thought I was in a really good spot. Oh, it's a crack saw. They didn't keep white for binding. Ren and six Leyline Binding and Scalding Tarn. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Maybe they already have the bolt in hand. Freaking South Catholic, Sack Catholic's not the worst here. Yes, I can't already beat that binding, can I? Let alone the rest of their hand. Just gain the life now in case they have bolt. Yeah, Beth Rosie was just like a tutor or something, or even Gris would have been okay. Oh. Alright, that's GG, I think. Okay. We got a chumper. And I have company next turn. Three tokens keeping me alive. That's nice. Oh, never mind, Dev. Well, that Ren ping, they need 2 damage from somewhere. Any 2 will do. Any 1 will do. Iteration, okay. Not a huge fan of Atraxa over Archon. It's easier to cast, but that's about it. It's better against Orvar. I mean, that's still upsides, obviously, but not seeing it. Okay, not dead yet. Just killed him. I'm due for a cat and then just a sack owl. It's not the end of the world to hit. Curio, wall of roots. Okay. And there's also just a evolve ability, I guess. Evolve. Yes. Kill your Atraxa. Should I attack Ren? I mean, I guess it can just chomp. Did I just mess up? Oh my god, I didn't use Wall of Roots. Thought I didn't have the mana. It didn't make a difference, but I could have sacked a token. Oh man, if I die to Renping, I may have failed. Oh, I mean, please just kill me. Like, not just with Renping. Please make it not close. Okay, bolts, nice. Oh, maybe I live. The rest of their hand's just trash. Loosey-goosey. Loosey-goosey. All right, let's see. Chris seems solid. Tracker seems fine. Loran, or some bigger could be okay. Reprieve seems good. I think I want the birds on the play. I mean, I think that combo is just too bad, honestly. It's just too hard. I'm gonna go with value plan again. Veil seems like it should be okay at some point. Endurance is usually solid against them. Then Knight seems fine too. Cut one birds, I guess. Maybe I should just cut Wall of Roots instead. All right, I'll keep. Why not? I'm not playing a Triome. Too many turn one plays for a Triome, I think. Oh, I didn't get second black. Let's see. It'll be fine. I have company in hand at four anyways. Nine of Autumn, Lauren, GG. Maybe I just say go here. I don't think they would expect reprieve. It's not a good Teferi bounce and it feels kind of bad. Okay, it's not the end of the world. No Ren. Okay, nice. Land. Land. Think Sango is 4 mana is also fine. I don't know if they still have Spell Pierce against me after sideboard. They might have creativity, but just figured they were getting got by too many. Oh man, they have that card too. I said go with 4 mana up, and they still cycled one. Oh god. I mean, what am I supposed to do? The company's not exactly getting better. I think Reprieve first may be better the way my deck is set up. And then now what? No creativity's coming. Potentially creativity for two. If I play Yogg, I can like Yogg, pitch endurance. Kill one of the 1/1s. Man, Bowmaster would be so good here again. Oh man. Could hit a Grist. Could just kind of overpower them. Let's just cast a company. I feel like I should be able to hit decent enough. This Samwise plus Familiar at least kind of threaten the combo. Probably the way to go. It's fragile, but think it's fine. I'm just not in a great spot here. Could play my own Hollow Moonlight. It's another card that'd be nice with the Wall of Roots, keeping that up for company or. So, what do they have? Atraxa and what? Atraxa and Archon, Atraxa and Seri Emissary. What's it gonna be? Elishnorn and Archon. Me, it's probably game. Yeah, I just need to wait, wait to have Bowmaster to play this deck again. Can I hit anything? Can bring back thingy, kill. Maybe just kill the Archon in the meantime. What's the sequencing here? I guess Chris is. I guess they're equally bad against Lightning Bolt and equally bad against Binding. I'm not a big fan of the aggressive Chi-Chi's, but it's fine. All right, well, that's not so bad for a first try. Let's see. Yeah, I think my next build would almost definitely not include Rosie. And Skurio's just too fragile. It's not even good against a one ring two if they're popping off. I feel like there's gonna be too many decks that don't care about it. I think there's a visual bug. No, lag maybe. Anyways, yeah, I would play four, probably try four Bowmaster. And maybe four Grists, four Yogg, something like that. Maybe Bowmaster and Asmo. And forget about the company angle. Hollow Moonlight's kind of a scary card. Spell Pierce kind of a scary card. It is nice if your deck like doesn't care about Spell Pierce that much and stuff. But yeah, I think the deck, the combo is definitely interested, and I'll be playing more of it. As always, if you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a great week, and I'll see y'all next time. Take care, everyone.